So, all of you RF system Canon users, including myself, I have something really awesome for you today. But before we get to it, roll that intro, baby. I'm a whole beast mode, yeah, kicking both feet though, yeah, all got veto, yeah, blood like C4, yeah, good low, swing low, yeah, cape like hero, yeah, double M zeros, yeah, double M zeros, yeah, yeah. What's up, all my creative peeps? Neil here, and today I got something really special for you in the form of a lens that would be perfect for your RF camera, and that's currently the Canon EOS R or the RP, and soon to be announced R5 and R6. So, what I wanted to talk to you about is lenses, and this one in particular, because as we know, RF lenses are very, very expensive. Even though Canon does plan to come out with some budget options here soon in the form of some new lenses that they are announcing with their July 9th announcement. But for now, if you're looking to get something that is not on back order, that does not cost an arm and a leg, what I would recommend, and the one I've been using, is this one here, which is the Tokina 16-28 f2.8. This lens for $400 is really, really nice. The lens itself is very, very rugged, if you will. It's beefy. It does have a nice all-metal construction, obviously besides the manual focus and the zoom range. Again, 16 to 28. Everything is really solid on it. I mean, I love it. It does have basically a lens hood, but this lens hood is built into the lens itself, and I want to talk to you about that. That's one thing that I'm not particularly happy with, having it built in, because what that means is that you can't basically use any sort of filter, ND filter, polarizing filter, anything like that. But we'll get back to that more in a minute. So the Tokina 16-28 is an f2.8, and the reason why I want to talk about this lens is because it's only $400. Now, you have a nice build quality in it. You have nice metal housing in the back. And from what I can tell, it's not weather sealed because it does not have a gasket in the back. But the front of the lens is cool. It has this little aspherical shape to it. And that's another reason why you can't mount any sort of, you know, filter to it and whatnot. But for the price and the performance of what this lens gives you, I think it's an absolutely low-hanging fruit that you should consider for your RF mount system. Again, this can go on the Canon EOS R and the RP. And the cool thing about it is, a lot of people think because it's Tokina 11-16, which is a very popular lens, that this lens is not for full frame. Guess what? It is for full frame. When I ordered it, I didn't realize that either. I thought, oh, it's going to be just like the 11-16. It's actually not. In 4K video mode, you get the entire screen, and then when you switch over to 1080, which I'll show you some b-roll of that, there's no vignetting. There's no sort of kind of like crop or kind of black circle around the actual image. It doesn't specifically say it was full frame, but I'm going to say it is, because of the simple fact that you don't get that vignette even in 1080p. And of course, even with the 11-16 Tokina, when you shoot in 4K, you don't get that vignette, but if you shoot in 1080, you do get the vignette. With this lens, you do not. So this is the ATX Pro model, IFX version, and I can't say many more good things about it besides it's an absolute steal. Now, is it the sharpest lens? No, not by any means, but it's still good for video. Actually, I took some photos with it because I was waiting on my 85mm lens to come in, and the photo surprisingly came out really well. And I'll pop some of those on the screen for you as well. And as far as the video quality, it looks pretty good. I was able to shoot over the past weekend a wedding video, wedding film, what have you, with this lens. And I found it to do terrific. Autofocus was good, even adapted to the Canon EOS R because this is an EF lens. But even adapted, the autofocus worked great. The tracking worked great. It didn't do heavy, basically focus breathing when I was trying to get focus on a subject that was moving fast, or still subjects for that matter. And also, as you see, it does have manual focus. You got autofocus and manual focus. And the cool thing is, if you want to switch to manual focus on the fly, you just pop that little basically ring down and you're in manual focus mode. So you're able to use that and basically pull your focus manually. And then when you're ready to go back to autofocus, you just pop that right up. So that's a cool little feature to it. Now let's talk about the cons. One of the cons being is, like I talked about earlier, it does have this built-in lens hood, which you cannot take off no matter what. It's just not coming off. It's built into the front part element of the lens. So that means you can't use any sort of ND filter with it. But if you're in conditions where you can control the lighting, whether that's artificial or whether that's ambient light, then obviously you can control the lighting and try to shoot wide open if you want to. With pictures, if you wanted to do pictures at the 28 millimeter focal length, obviously you can control that really easy by adjusting your shutter. But for video, you do have to be mindful of whether or not you can control the lighting situations. Now, you can of course adjust for light with video, even though it's 2.8, and you can basically stop down, but you do lose that depth of field once you stop down an aperture, which I think we all know. Second thing, this would not be a vlogging lens simply because of the weight. Obviously, it weighs more than the body. I think it comes in at around almost 3 pounds. So it would be very front heavy. You can do it, but here's the main reason why I say you shouldn't. The simple fact is when it is trying to autofocus, the autofocus motor is very, very loud. So I will actually let you hear that and how loud that is. And the reason why that presents a problem is because most vloggers have microphones on top of their cameras in this shoe mount here. And if you have a microphone, it's definitely going to pick up the sounds of this trying to focus. Again, you can do manual focus, but I don't know many people that do manual focus when they're vlogging, except Cody Warner. Shout out to you, brother. But yeah, the lens is just very, very noisy when it goes to focus. It sounds like clackling, clack, 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 and you'll hear that. That's why I don't recommend it for vlogging. Now, if you're just doing videos and projects, and if or you want to shoot at any of those focal lengths, like 28, maybe for some up-close portraits, or if you want to do landscapes with this, this is a nice wide angle at 16 millimeter. So just think about how you would be using it and whether those focal ranges will work for you. Again, I don't recommend it for vloggers. You can't put an ND filter on it. I knew that going into it, it's fine. But other than that, it's really, really well built. Again, it's a tank, it's beefy. It will work with your full frame EOS R or RP, and then the new models coming out as well. Even adapted with the Canon EF to RF adapter, the lens works good. It's really good as far as autofocus goes. Focus breathing is good as well. So yeah, this is a pretty good lens that you should consider for $400. If you need something that's wide angle, you should definitely consider this lens. It's only $400 and I like it, you know, and I have shown you some video footage as well as some pictures that I've done with it. And I'm gonna play around with it a little bit more because I've only had it for about 3 weeks now, but first impressions really is that it's good. You know, besides the ND filter and the loud focusing, it's a pretty good lens. I mean, you can't really beat it for a wide angle lens at that price point. So $399. And the reason why I wanted to get it is because I needed something wide and I wanted something affordable. And again, you know, that's the reason why I do these kind of reviews on the channel, is for budget videography and photography gear. So let me know in the comments what you thought about this lens, the footage that you've seen, the pictures that you've seen, and let me know if this would be a consideration for your camera body. I would genuinely like to know. And if this is your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing to the channel. It helps out tremendously and I would greatly appreciate it. And if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave a thumbs up for this video as well, because that will help out too. So until the next time, on the next review, the next video, hasta luego.